Oh yeah, Tesla update 36.2. And with this update, you get a 5% power increase. So my question to all my Tesla folks out there is, who else ready to go to the racetrack and test out that extra power? I know I am with my standard plus Model 3, but we're gonna jump into this video and just talk about and highlight the things that came out in this update. And it starts right now. What's happening, everybody? You're in the building with Lamont Tyson. This is Lamont Tyson Life Gains channel. I am a Tesla owner. I bought mine in September 2019, 2 months ago. And my channel was started in tech, even though it has morphed into reviewing movies and TV shows. But I will be reviewing Tesla. So if you're finding me for the first time, please subscribe to my channel and turn on the notifications so when I drop videos, you get them. For those of you that are new to how Tesla does their business, because I'm still new, but I'm learning, that's why I'm doing these videos. If your car is configured a certain way, it may take you longer to get an update, and also where you live at may take you longer. I just got my update yesterday, whereas people I've seen in Michigan got it like Saturday. Based upon your car's configuration, whether you have self-driving mode, purchase, what may have you, kind of dictates what you get in some of these updates. So let's just go through them. One big one that a lot of people are really, really happy about is scheduled departure. It allows you to set a time to have your car charged by. And so what that means is, let's say you go to work at 8 o'clock in the morning and you've charged your car, they say set it at 90%. The car is gonna charge like 85, and then maybe it's gonna wake up at like 7 p.m. or whenever, however long it takes your car to finish getting to 90, and it'll charge for you. Why is that important? Because you want your battery warm. That allows the regen to work properly and efficiently, and it helps the car be more smooth. So you definitely like that. A lot of people have wanted that one. And for people that live somewhere where the power bill is expensive, it allows you to schedule this thing out in a way that you can avoid the peak times. So that's gonna really be a big plus for everybody that lives in those areas. And also just getting the battery warmed up so that you can go. Auto navigation, ladies and gentlemen, we're taking steps closer and closer to fully autonomous driving. Literally, you just sit your ass in the car, put your hands up, and one of these days it's just gonna go from A to B. You're not gonna have to do nothing. But what this is it kind of understands where you're going day to day. And if you turn it on, it'll just go ahead and navigate you to that route. And you can also sync it with your calendar. So if you got a work calendar and you need to know where you're going or what may have you, it'll go ahead and sync you to that as well. That's not something that I'm gonna use much because my route varies day to day with the kind of work that I do. But I'm happy that they put that up there because I hear a lot of people was requesting that one. And the next one that I started this video off with, the power increase, ladies and gentlemen. I took my Tesla out there this morning just to see if it gave me a little bit more kick. And I did feel a little bit more kick. Now, I'm not out here gonna be proclaiming that the thing is about to take off like a rocket ship, but you can feel a little bit more power. It does have a little bit more get up and go. And everybody who's in the EV car industry, you already know, EVs just move faster, baby. So the car picked up pretty well. I'm satisfied with it, but I was satisfied with it before this update came. Now, my favorite one of them all is the stop mode. You are basically one pedal driving now. You've got a great increase to the regen, which in the beginning, if you're not familiar with regen braking, it takes some time for you to just kind of understand how to ease your foot off the gas pedal a little bit so that the car slows to a point where you don't have to hit the brake. I mastered this thing within 3 days because it was just cool to me. But if you're new to it, it's gonna take some time. And now it's gonna completely put the car in hold mode when you go to a stoplight, when you ease off the gas or you don't gotta touch the brake. And it just helps give more energy back to the battery. I really, really love this feature. This is my favorite feature of them all. And it works in reverse as well, ladies and gentlemen. I'm gonna break this down for what you're getting in Model 3. So if you got a Model 3 Standard Plus like I got, or you've got the long, the medium range Model 3, you all are gonna get the scheduled departure, you're gonna get automatic navigation, you're gonna get the power increase, you get the stopping mode, and you get the increase at the supercharger. And I haven't done that one yet. So if you guys have done that, leave me comments below. And you can see the comparison of what you get with the other Model 3s if you have those. So ladies and gentlemen, that's the update. And I will be bringing back a video that I did. I just took my Model 3 on its first road trip from North Carolina to Washington, D.C. And I ran into a supercharging station in Washington, D.C. where my car would not charge at all, but it charges at all the other ones. And so I'm going to put that on the next video I do, which will be my Tesla road trip, first road trip. And just leave me comments about how you guys love your car, different things that I might have missed in this update that you have on your Model 3 that I didn't mention that you like. That's going to do it for this video. Don't forget to like my video. Please comment, subscribe, go get yourself a life game. Converse with me about your Model 3s and your electric cars and what you see coming in the industry. And until the next Sex is Hell video, I'll see you.